in session. Y'all have a...
I now call to be heard cause number 13-1367, K2, the state of Texas versus Gregory Raymond Kelley. Mr. Dick?
Yes, Your Honor. Pursuant to a mandate issued by the Court of Criminal Appeals of Texas on Monday, the state is tendering its motion to dismiss the prosecution of Gregory Kelley.
And that justice would prevail. Your case was polarizing and drew the attention of many in our community. Then came the jury guilty. And on that day in July of 2014, when you were sentenced to 25 years in prison, many participants and onlookers concluded that justice was served. We now know differently. 3 years later, in the spring of 2017, the daunting task of sorting out what happened, what was missed, and what was not explored in your case fell upon Mr. Hampton, Mr. Dick, Mr. Roberts, Mr. Gonzalez, and Ms. Chapman, as well as this court. It required a full autopsy of the trial and a new investigation of the facts. I want to applaud Mr. Hampton, Mr. Dick, and his distinguished team of appellate attorneys for their exhaustive efforts and diligence in this case. For me, as the judge presiding over the writ proceedings, it was difficult to step outside the realm of a trial court and dissect the work of others and disturb processes that are indeed foundational to our jurisprudence. But when I did, I was convinced that the guilty verdict was unjust and that you, sir, should be exonerated. So I did what was within my power to do. I released you from prison. I recommended to the Court of Criminal Appeals that relief be granted, that you be declared innocent as afforded by the case law establishing this ground for relief. This and the other findings I made are the most that I can do for you. I cannot undo the damage done, reclaim years lost, or restore your life to what it was as a senior in high school. And with the regrets that I have for you and your family's suffering, I regret that there is another injustice that I cannot remedy, the absence of justice for the child against whom a horrific crime was committed. It is truly a systemic failure. For that, I am sorry. But I'm also mindful that we are here today on the eve of Thanksgiving and that there is so much to be thankful for. Thankful that you have ascended out of the valley of the circumstances that resulted from this case, and thankful that this is also true for the system of justice in Williamson County. Don't take the system of justice for granted. Let us acknowledge the price, thankful for the efforts and our ability to correct the wrongs of this case and of others. Let us be thankful that the justice system, though stretched and tested, ultimately worked and that justice prevailed for you. Mr. Kelley, when you received the jury's verdict at your trial, you stood, I believe, at that table right over there, for comfort of your family. So at this time, I'd like to invite your mom and Gabri to stand by you as we bring this season to a close and start anew. Good morning. The Court of Criminal Appeals has granted habeas corpus relief. I can now say what you deserve to hear publicly and on behalf of the citizens of Williamson County and of the state of Texas. Mr. Kelley, with the full weight of the law, vision of justice, as much as humanity can provide, you have carried your burden under the law, proving your innocence. You claim to the citizens are innocent. And that you are fully exonerated. And therefore, at this time, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to do something I've never done before, but I think this occasion, in our system of justice, the gavel has importance. It signifies that what was is no longer. And at this time, the state's motion to dismiss the indictment is granted. What was is no longer. Congratulations. And I would like to, at this time, if you would approach the bench, I'd like to hand you a copy of the order of dismissal in this cause. Congratulations. Is there anything further on behalf of the applicant in this matter?
Yeah, I think you'd like to say something.
All right. You may do what you need to do, Mr. Kelley.
Truth was the goal here. Ultimately, truth would be the catalyst that would supply justice for all parties that were wronged. The Cedar Park Police Department deprived not only me, but the victim here. They pursued me to be the guy and the only guy by completely ignoring a mountain of evidence mountain of evidence that pointed to my innocence and someone else's guilt. The same man later drugged and raped multiple victims while I sat. Fighting for my life. Due process is a liberty that everyone is entitled to while living in the greatest country in the world. If a police department doesn't feel the same way, I would be scared to death to live in that city. No one should ever question if their voice should or would be heard. To the victim and his family, I'm absolutely sorry you have to go through this. Believe me, your opinion matters. For 6 years, I not only had to fight to prove to the state I didn't do this, but I also had to fight to prove to you that I didn't do this. The justice system failed me and you. Today I received justice while you remain failed. If anything is going to drive me to seek accountability from certain individuals, it's going to be because all victims deserve justice the first time around. I pray you have peace. To my family, my brothers, my sister, my relatives, thank you so much for being by my side. You're the best family that anybody could ever ask for. I have the best mother. I have a praying mother. She never failed to visit me while I was in prison every week. The fear of me being torn away from them again is over. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life creating wonderful memories with the people I hold near and dear to my heart. To my soon-to-be bride, Gabri, women like you. I'm the most strong, faithful, beautiful woman on the face of this earth. I can only imagine the strength it took to faithfully stick by me. As teenagers, you never doubted me. You carried the burden of being attached to me while the world was calling me a monster. As we fought to prove my innocence, you never stopped unconditionally loving me. You kept me alive. You gave me hope to come home, and I love you so much. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. To my second mom and dad, Tracy and David Anderson. Most would agree that a child is a reflection of their parents. Thank you for treating me like your son, the son you never had. You took me in and provided for me after my release and made sure I was taken care of. If there is any couple Gabriel and I look at to as inspiration, it is you two. Most people dislike their in-laws, but I love you. To my brothers in Christ at the WIN unit, thank you for believing in me. Thank you for pouring into me in my time of need. Thank you for teaching me God's word. Prison walls were meant to keep criminals in, and they should, but they can't keep God out.
Amen.
I believe one of the most powerful things is to give a broken man a Bible. Thank you, District Attorney Shonda. I can imagine how much this weighed heavy on you. Thank you for your countless hours of reviewing my case and ruling in the favor of. Thank you for reopening my case and seeking nothing but the truth. You're the change of Williamson County. Thank you, Judge King. I can only imagine everything you had to go through. You were kind of thrown into this. Thank you for your countless hours for reviewing my case. Thank you for ruling in the favor of truth and justice. You are the epitome of honorable. Thank you, Keith Anthony, for believing in me when I was the most broken. Thank you for taking this on, and you have absolutely no idea what you're getting yourself into. If Marvel Comics ever wanted to create an Attorney Man, I say slaps his spandex on Keith because he's the man for the job. You're a superhero, man. Thank you, Jake Bryden. Where are you? You had no idea who I was days after my conviction. You called my broken mother and promised her you would do everything you could to fight for me. You provided in ways no man would. But you felt led to. Until I heard your mouth open to say my life. You are the mouth of the South. Lastly, but certainly not least, none of this would be possible without giving God the ultimate glory. The night I was convicted and thrown into a cell, just in this county jail right next door, I was scared for my life. I didn't know what to expect. I didn't know what my fate was. I wanted to be alive, to see my family. I was absolutely terrified to go to prison. The night I was put in that cell, I surrendered my life to Jesus Christ. I desperately begged God to intervene. I knew nothing about him. Couldn't quote a scripture. Couldn't tell you who. Day after day, as I sat alone in my cell, all alone, I fell in love with getting to know Jesus through his word. Because I could find peace without dealing with hate. I asked him to save me. He did every bit of that. There on that cell floor, and now here this morning. If you asked me how I did it, it was solely love of Jesus Christ. James 2-4 says, consider joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Work that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. God has the ability to change a situation, a life, and a heart. My story is his glory.
Thank you all for being here today. The proceedings are concluded. Mr. Kelley, if you'd like to approach and get a certified copy of that order, you're excused.